Setting a default domain. Words so important we featured them in the title of this video. We'll cover the basics of root domains, subdomains, and default domains, and then we'll set our default domain for a project or site hosted in Webflow. What is a root domain? It's this. It's the domain you purchase when you're buying it from a registrar. If you bought pinkthesaurus.com, that's the root domain. No www, nothing at all in front of it. That's the root. What about a subdomain? A subdomain is the part in front of Pink Thesaurus, or whatever your site is. Best example, www. That's a subdomain. How about a default domain? A default domain is where you want someone to end up, regardless of what they type in. If you set the www version as your default, that means visiting pinkthesaurus.com will take you to www.pinkthesaurus.com. That's the default domain. Finally, how do we set it? Well, we already showed it about 12 seconds ago, but for the sake of clarity, let's show it again with a bit more context. From your project, let's go over to Project Settings. And once we're there, we'll move ourselves over to the Hosting tab. This is where we have any and all custom domains featured. And all we have to do is click the tiny house. That's it. We made that version the default. How do you know? Because there's another tiny house inside a box that also says default, which means it's the default. All we gotta do, publish. That's it. So, 10-second review. Root domain, pinkthesaurus.com. Subdomain, something in front. Default domain, where it takes users. How do we set it? Tiny house. A house so tiny it could times up. But that's a quick overview of default domains in Webflow hosting.